Friends at Dunkin' Donuts are going to help me explain the fiscal cliff mess to you the way that only Dunkin' Donuts can. But if you want to understand why we keep staying in this debt trouble, I have two words for you: post office. Now, I love my mailman. He's a great guy. I'm sure your mail person is a great person too. But the post office lost $16 billion just in 2012, not to mention another $11 billion in payments they were supposed to make to the pension program that they did not make, that we have to cover for them. And billions more are going to be lost in the future. And you are going to be on the hook for every one of those dollars. Now, admittedly, $15 billion compared to the $16 trillion debt we have right now, or the $1.1 trillion we spent last year that we don't have, it's small potatoes. But the post office is a perfect example of why we keep digging this debt hole deeper, why Tim Geithner is saying, hey, we need another debt ceiling increase right away. It's because everybody in Washington knows the post office doesn't work, but they won't fix it. And the reason the post office doesn't work is because mail, to use a technical term I learned in economic school, sucks. Nobody wants mail. Everybody hates mail. When was the last time you had a problem and thought, I know the perfect solution. I will get out a piece of paper, I will write on it with my pen, I will fold it up, I will put it in an envelope, I will stick it in a box, and I will wait for someone to walk to my house and walk away with it. Ben Franklin solved his problems this way. You don't. Nobody uses mail. We have the internet for the stuff we need immediately, and we have FedEx for stuff if you have to actually send a piece of paper somewhere. If they canceled your postal service right now, if you went to, say, one day a week mail right now, would you even notice? Nobody would. The only people who would notice would be the people who send you catalogs and the people who send you junk mail. Because nobody under the age of the Golden Girls cast uses mail. And that's why it loses $16 billion. Earlier this week on the show, we had a little old lady trying to get people to write letters this holiday season. You know who was on the TV show with her? The post office going, please, please, please send mail. Because they know, just like the folks in the car, in the horse and buggy business, the cars are taking over. Your day is done. I love you, post office, but bye-bye. We just can't afford you anymore. Shannon, that's the natural truth.
Well, call me Rose or Dorothy, because I put something in the mail yesterday. So, anyway, or that. All right, Michael.